Okay. Remember yesterday, we learned new vocabulary about countries, languages, regions, okay? So the first part, exercise 1A, is about countries. So letter A says, complete the names of the countries, then write the countries in the chart below. Okay, so let's start. Number one, we have Spain. Number two, number three, number four, number five, number six, number seven, number eight, number nine, number 10, 11, 12, okay, 13, 14, and 15. Okay, perfect. Okay, now here we're going to complete the chart with your personal information. Let's see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 questions. Okay, let's begin with Daniela. Okay, Dani, can you tell me the first line? I know a lot about... Number one, Daniela, I know a lot about. Okay, that is the number two. I don't know. The number one, Dani? Okay. Perla, do you speak English in... Okay, one more time, Perla. I love the food from... Okay. And Daniela, I don't want to go to... Morocco. Okay. Exercise B says, look at the pictures. What kinds of food are these dishes? Write the nationalities. Number one, we have Japanese food. Number two, it would be number three. And number four. Italy, yes. Italy or Italian? Italian, yes. And number two, France or French? Yes, correct. Okay, exercise C says complete the chart. Food I like, food I don't like, food I want to try, and food I can cook. So let's start. Daniela, you're going to answer numbers 1 and 2. Perla, 3 and 4. So Daniela, food I like. Okay, and Daniela, one more time. Food I don't like. Okay, now Perla, food I want to try. South Korea or Korean? Yes, Korean. And food I can cook, Perla? Sushi, okay. Now let's continue with the second part, the second page. Okay. Here we have a crossword puzzle. So let's start with across, okay? Number two, there are no cities in this cold icy region. Well, it's Antarctica. Number six, this country is in both Europe and Asia. Seven, this large region includes Japan and South Korea. Yes. Nine, Beijing, Shanghai, and Hong Kong are in this country. 10, this long, thin country is in South America. Chile. Okay, let's continue with down. Number one, they speak both French and English in this North American country. Yes. Three, they speak this language in Turkey. Correct. For Rome, Venice, and Milan are cities in this European country. This large country is in Oceania. And number 8, they speak this language in Thailand. Thai, perfect. Okay, let's continue with exercise 3. Says, unscramble the questions, then write through answers. Okay, Daniela, what sports can your best friend play? Perla, number 2, question and answer, please. And the answer is okay. Daniela, number 3, question and answer. Can you speak? Okay. And Danny, number 4, question and answer. And your answer? And I remember that you also had to finish, okay, the exercise 2, remember in the student book, page 94, you only had to complete the chart with the names of countries. So are you here on this page, 94, in your student book? Okay, excellent. Well, let's start with the first region. We have Africa, and we have one country, Morocco. What else do you have? Egypt. Yes. That is not in Africa. The last one is not in Africa. It's in the Middle East. And Iraq also is not in Africa. Okay, so you have only, let me see, Egypt, Iraq, and Israel. They are not in Africa. Let me see here. We can think about South Africa, for example. Yes, they're in another place. In Africa, you can find South Africa, Tanzania. Okay. Now let's continue with Asia. We have Thailand. Yes, China too. Japan. Excellent. Yes. Turkey, yes. Europe. Spain, Russia. Poland. Okay. North America. Yes. Central America. En South America. Argentina, Brasil, Chile, Perú, Venezuela. Okay, perfect. Okay, so this was the homework that we had yesterday, okay? I remember yesterday we started with the lesson B. We finished with the lesson B. Okay. We only need to do this part, the exercise 3. But well, you can answer this with your personal information. Okay, so this was the lesson B. So let's do this. Okay, let's go back to the lesson B. I'm gonna do the last part of the lesson B. Are you ready? This is the lesson B, remember. But in the student book. Okay, so we are here. Okay, are you ready, Perla? Dani? Okay, let's see. Well, I'm going to read the questions and you're going to tell me your answers. Okay. So let's see. Question number one. It says, find someone who can make Indian food. So Perla and Dani, can you make Indian food? Yes or no? Can you make Indian food? Perlas. Who says no? ¿Perla or Dani? Or both. Both. Okay, so leave the space in blank, okay? Number two, do you have an American friend? Perla says, yes. Yes, I can, or yes, I do. Remember the question, do you have an American friend? Yes, I do. Okay, Perla says yes. And Daniela? No, I don't. Okay, in this case, when here you're supposed to write the names of your other partners, but well, it's just you. So on the line, instead of writing a name, you're going to write down the answer. Yes, I do, or maybe no, I don't. Okay. Like in the first one, yes, I can, or no, I can't, okay? Let's continue with number three. Can you speak three languages? Okay, so write down your answer. No, I can't. One more time, here on the line, here on the line. No, I can't, okay? Another question, do you like Brazilian music? Okay, so write down your answer. No, I don't. Okay. Do you know the capital city of Australia? Okay, so write that now. Can you name three countries beginning with C? Yes, we can. Excellent. And the last question. Do you know the name of a British band? verlas es no. Yes, okay, excellent. Well, as you can see, this is the last activity, okay, for the lesson B. Yesterday we started with this lesson, lesson B. And here we learn new vocabulary about countries, regions, nationalities, languages. Okay, so before going to the lesson C, I want you to tell me what do you remember about lesson B. Okay, yes, we talk about countries. Languages, yes. Nationalities. Okay, excellent. Wait, now let's see. Let's do something before we start with the class. Let's play just a little bit. Let's imagine that there is a circle. Okay. This is the handman. Okay. Yes, we talk about food also. Let's see. What, Perla? Oh my God. It's easy. It's not complicated, Perla. Okay, so let's start. Okay, tell me letters, please. A. Another letter? O. Ah, okay. Another one. Is that L or I? I, okay. Ah, oh, correct. Okay, continue, another letter. Okay, let's continue. Yes. Uh-huh. Es la ti. Cancino, cancino. What is that? Oh my God. I'm sorry. The thing is that I can't see. Oh, R. Yes. Let's continue. I want to see better. Is B. What else? B. Let's continue. L. Oh, no, I'm sorry, it's not there. No, no, no. That is not the correct place. Is give me a second. Is there? You're close, 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 close. Just let me move this one. You said P. What else? C. E. Okay, continue. N. You almost have the expression. Do you know what it says? Explaining what? Yes, correct. Explaining words. Well, this is the name of the lesson C, okay? Thank you. This is the name of the lesson C, explaining word. I mean, lesson C, as you know, it's about conversation strategy. So, it's here. Can you see? It's here. Explaining words. So, this is what we're going to learn today, how to explain words. Okay, so let's start with the first activity. 1A says circle the correct word to complete the sentence. It says coffee is a kind of food drink, dance, or music? So, what is coffee? Drink, yes. Coffee is a kind of drink. Okay, this is the correct word. As you can see in this sentence, what we are doing here is explaining the word coffee. So, what is mean? Coffee is a kind of drink. We're explaining that word. I have some examples here. One more time, remember today's lesson, we're going to learn how to explain words. So I have here some pictures. Okay, let's see. Well, I have these pictures. Okay, picture number one, it says anaco. Okay, anaco is this outfit, okay? This dress that you see here, well, it's called anaco. Then we have a snack, okay? They are cocadas. Well, everybody knows cocadas. Well, here in Acapulco, we know cocadas. Okay, we have another example. Here we have this musical instrument. Its name is charango. Okay, this is a musical instrument. And here we have a Japanese dish. Its name is yosenabi. As you can see, some of these words are foreign words. Okay, so we don't know these words here in Mexico, but except cocadas, okay? So we have an anaco, that is this dress. We have this musical instrument. We have a charango, and we have this Japanese dish that is yosenabi. So now we are going to start explaining these words, okay? So here I have the examples. We have these expressions, kind of. We're going to use kind of, okay, for general information. Okay, kind of for general information. And we're going to use this expression, kind of like, for specific information. Okay. So I'm going to explain this. First of all, I know that you like to take notes of the exercises. So if we don't have enough time, I mean, if you don't have enough time to take notes of this part, don't worry. After the class, I'm going to send you these exercises on WhatsApp, okay? So you can take notes later at home, or you can review, or you can study, okay? So don't worry if you don't have time to take notes of all the questions, I mean of all the examples, okay? As I said before, after the class, I'm gonna send them to you on WhatsApp, okay? So you're gonna have this information later. So let's start explaining. Remember, I show you the pictures. So let's start by giving general information using kind of. The first question that we have here is, what's a charango? Okay, that's the question. What's a charango? One more time, remember this is a charango, okay? So what's a charango? It's a kind of musical instrument. We are giving here what? General information. It's a kind of musical instrument. Question number two, what's an anaco? It's a kind of traditional dress from Peru, okay? What are cocadas? They are a kind of snack. What's yosenabi? It's a kind of traditional food from Japan. Well, as you can see, we're using kind of, okay, kind of, to give general information. Now, we have the same questions, but this time we're going to give specific information. What's a charango? It's kind of like a guitar. What's a naco? It's kind of like a dress. What are cocadas? They are kind of like candy. And what's yusenabi? It's kind of like soup. Well, as you can see here, one more time, remember, we are giving general information. It's a kind of musical instrument. Specific, it's kind of like a guitar. We're saying specific because we are comparing two things. Okay, we're comparing two things that are similar. So we are saying that a charango is similar with a guitar. Second one, a naco. We're saying that a naco is like a dress. So they are similar, okay, with a dress. Cocadas, they are kind of like candy. So again, we're making a comparison. Cocadas are like candy. And the last one was yusenabi. Yusenabi is kind of like soup or is like a soup. So we're making a comparison in two things that are similar. So remember, we're going to use kind of like for specific information. Remember, you're comparing with another similar thing. And we have general information. Okay, so we have two different ways of explaining words. So do you understand this part? Excellent. Okay, so let's see. Remember, we have general information and we have here the specific information. So I'm gonna type here one. So here you have the two explanations. What's a charango? It's a kind of musical instrument. It's kind of like a guitar. I'm going to give another example. Okay. What's a guacamaya? It's a kind of bird, for example. It's a kind of bird. It's not like. So, what's a guacamaya? It's a kind of bird. This is general information. It's a kind of bird. Or it's kind of like a parrot. So, you're comparing. You pay attention with the second example, you are comparing with another similar thing. Okay, so you have two examples. Okay, do you have questions? Are you sure? Let's see. Okay, let's think about food. Pay attention to this picture. So, what is this? What do you see? Okay, let's see. This is my question. What's pozole? You say it's a kind of food. Okay, that's general. And specific. That is general information, because if you say Mexican food, I can think about I can think about tostadas, enchiladas, quesadillas. So that is general information. It's a kind of Mexican food. That's general information. It's a kind of Mexican food. That's general information. Think about something similar. About this. Can you see? So you are making a comparison with something that is similar. Yes? It's kind of like a soup. Okay, now let's pay attention to this. So these are enchiladas. So what are enchiladas? How do you explain this? In this case, well, this is plural. I will use there. Now, give me the idea. But if you're saying tacos, that is specific information. Okay, they are a kind of food, that's general. They are kind of like tacos. Excellent. Yes, you are correct. They are. They are a kind of food, they are a kind of Mexican food. Okay, general information. They are. Tacos, is they are kind of like tacos. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Okay, now let's continue with the book. here. Well, here in your book, we have a conversation. We have a picture of Adam and Yuki, and we have a server. First of all, pay attention to the picture. Let's think about the place. Tell me, where are they? Okay, so where are they? In a restaurant, okay. Maybe they are in a restaurant. Okay, so, well, I'm gonna play the audio and you're going to listen to this conversation. Remember, we have Adam, Yuki, and we have a server. I want you to listen to the conversation, and then we're going to answer this question. What do Yuki and Adam order? Okay, so listen carefully, and then you're going to tell me the answer. So let's see.
Page 90, lesson C. They're a kind of candy. One, conversation strategy. Explaining words. Listen, what do Yuki and Adam order?
Are you ready to order?
Yes. Can I have a large diet soda?
A large diet soda?
Yes, please.
Can I have coffee ice cream with chocolate sprinkles?
Sure.
Okay.
What are sprinkles?
They're a kind of candy. You can put them on things like ice cream and cake. They're kind of like sugar.
Oh, I know. You can get them in Japan too.
Okay. Excellent. Okay, so now let's see one more time. What do Yuki and Adam order? A large diet soda only. Coffee ice cream with chocolate sprinkles. Excellent. Okay, now pay attention to this part. And here it says, Norris. Okay, it says, Norris how Adam uses a kind of and kind of like. He's explaining a new word to Yuki. Find examples in the conversation. Pay attention here. Yuki is asking this question. What are sprinkles? Okay. And then Adam begins explaining this word. They are a kind of candy. Okay, here we have, they are a kind of candy. You have the answer below. They are a kind of candy. They are kind of like sugar. So as you can see, Adam is using a kind of and kind of like to explain this word, sprinkles, okay, to Yuki. Okay. Do you have questions about this part, Dani, Perla?
Okay.
Excellent. So now, okay, let's move to the letter B. Okay, exercise B. Says match each picture with an explanation, then take turns asking a partner. Okay, we have four pictures here in letter B, and here on this side we have the explanation. So read the explanation, and here inside the box you're going to write the correct number. Okay, so let's do it, please. Are you ready? Yes. Okay, so let's check. It says it's a kind of musical instrument. It's like a guitar. Number two, a buzuki. Okay. It's a kind of bread. It's kind of like a pancake. Yes, tortilla. It's a kind of drink. It's kind of like a milkshake. Yes. It's a kind of dress. It's a traditional outfit. Number one. Excellent. Okay, so let's move to the second part. Okay, so we are here. Well, let's continue with exercise two. We have the strategy plus like. So here we're going to learn another ways to use this word like. Here it says you can use like to give examples. In conversation, like is one of the top 15 words. It has other meanings. I like Brazilian food. What's Thailand like? Sprinkles are like sugar. We have an example. You can put sprinkles on things like ice cream and cake. So let's pay attention to the examples here, okay? Example number one, I like Brazilian food. So here we're talking about our likes. For example, when you say things like, I like movies, I like to play volleyball, I like to swim, I like to go out with my friends, I like to eat cake, I like dogs, I like cats. So you're talking about things that you like, okay? That's example number one. Example number two, we have a question. And this question has the word like at the end. What's Thailand like? Okay, with this question, we're asking for a description of this place. What's Thailand like? We can say, it's interesting, it's amazing, it's exciting, it's beautiful, it's wonderful, it's cheap, it's expensive, etc. We're giving a description of the place. Another example would be what's the weather like? So with what's the weather like, we're asking for a description of the weather. We can say it's sunny, it's warm, it's windy, it's rainy, it's cold, it's freezing, okay? Another example, what's your sister like? And you can start describing your sister. You can talk about her personality. Ah, my sister is happy, intelligent, optimistic, strict, etc. Okay? So with the questions, we're asking for a description. Okay? Now let's continue with example number 3. It says, sprinkles are like sugar. In this example, well, we're making a comparison. We're saying that the sprinkles are similar with sugar. One more time. Remember the examples that I gave you at the beginning? A charango is like a guitar. Okay. Enchiladas are like tacos. Okay. A naco is like a dress. Cocadas are like snack. Okay. A guacamaya is like a parrot. So we're giving examples. We are making a comparison. Okay. So these are the 3 different ways in which we can use the word like. Okay. Do you understand, ladies? Do you have questions about this? Now, can you tell me one example for each of them, please? So give me your examples. One, and one. I like ice cream. Mm-hmm. What's your mother and what is the word like? Yes, what's your mother like? And the other one? Okay, frappe is like, because that's singular. Frappe is like. It's like a smoothie. Yes, correct, perfect. That's nice. Okay, now let's do the exercise below. Okay, you're going to answer this part. It says, imagine a tourist is asking these questions about your country. Answer the questions and then practice with a partner. Number one, what are good souvenirs to buy? Well, things like, think about good souvenirs to get here in Mexico. You can think about traditional outfits, candies, postcards, I don't know. Number two, do you ever see people in traditional clothes? Well, you sometimes see things like, think about traditional clothes. I don't know, huipiles, huaraches, rebozos, sarapes, Think about traditional things. 3, is the food spicy like Indian food? You're going to say yes or no. And number 4, what are good places to visit? Oh, places like, think about good places to visit here around the country. Yes, you can think about here, Acapulco, Los Cabos, Chichen Itza, etc. Okay, so let's do this exercise, please. Okay, go ahead. Are you ready? Yes, vote. Yes, that's good. Okay. Okay, let's see. Number 1, what are good souvenirs to buy? Well, things like... Okay, number 2, do you ever see people in traditional clothes? Well, you sometimes see things like... Yes. 3, is the food spicy like Indian food? is the food or the food is? And the food is, because you are answering, remember the question. The food is spicy like Indian food, okay? The food is spicy like Indian food. And number four, where are good places to visit? We have places like yes, that would be a nice idea, Oaxaca. Well, now let's move to the exercise three. In exercise three, well, this is a listening activity. Okay, exercise three. Well, here we have four pictures. And as you can see here on your left, on the left, we have the words. A mosquito, yogurt, a boutique, a waltz. So we are going to write the words here below the correct picture. Okay. Picture one, we have the example. This is yogurt. Picture two, what is it? Okay, picture three. Yes, and picture four. Mosquito, excellent. Okay. Here it says, can you guess what languages the words are from? Complete the chart. We're going to find now the nationalities of these words. Okay, the first word is yogurt. Do you have any idea about the nationality of this word? So where is it from? Try to make some predictions. Remember, we're just guessing. Where is it from? The word yogurt. Try to predict. From Greece. Yes, we're going to find out, okay? Number two, boutique. What is it from? Friends would be number three, waltz. You say Mexico. And number four, mosquito. Okay, well, I'm going to play the audio. You're going to listen again to Adam and Yuki. In this conversation, they are talking about these words and the languages they are from. Listen carefully. And here, below the name, you're going to write down the language these words are from. Okay, so listen carefully, please, and complete your chart.
Page 91. Page 91. Three. Listening and speaking. What language is it from? B. B. Listen to more of Adam and Yuki's conversation. Check your guesses. One.
We use a lot of English words in Japanese. Do you use a lot of foreign words in English?
Yeah. There are hundreds and hundreds. For example, look at your smoothie. It has yogurt in it.
Yogurt?
Yeah, yogurt. That's a Turkish word.
Turkish? Really?
Yes.
So now I can say I like Turkish food, huh?
Yep.
Two.
Okay, tell me another one.
Well, you see that small store over there?
The clothing store?
Yeah. Well, it's also called a boutique.
Oh, yeah? So a boutique is a kind of store. So what language is it from? Is it Italian?
No, it's French. It's the French word for store.
So that's why boutiques are expensive. They're French.
Three.
And then there's waltz. That's another foreign word we use.
What's a waltz? How do you say it? Waltz?
Yes, waltz. It's a kind of dance. A slow dance.
Oh, okay.
Well, anyway, it comes from German. You speak some German, right?
Well, only a little. I mean, I can say my name and I can say I can't speak German very well.
Oh, that's funny.
Four.
Ow. Hate mosquitoes.
But they love you, huh?
Yeah. They look at me and they see dinner.
There's another foreign word.
What? Dinner?
No. Mosquito.
What is it? It sounds like a Mexican word. Like burrito.
Well, it is Spanish.
Oh, yeah. They speak Spanish in Mexico.
Do you have the answers? Okay, so number one, yogurt. What's the nationality? Turkish, excellent. Number two, boutique. Yes, number three, waltz. No, they didn't say Indian. It's German. And number four, mosquito. No. Spanish. Okay, you're welcome. Okay, questions, Perla, Dani? No. Okay, we're going to do the exercise for tomorrow, okay? Exercise four is tomorrow. Okay, well, as you can see today, we work with the lesson C, okay? So before you leave, tell me, what did you learn in lesson C? What did you learn in lesson C? Yes. How to use kind of like. Okay. Perfect. Okay. Well, I just want to show you that I already sent, can you see? I already sent the exercises to our WhatsApp group. So the exercises that we practice today are on WhatsApp. If you want to study or if you want to take notes, okay, they are there, already there. So the homework for tomorrow . Okay, so you're going to work here in your workbook. Okay, you're going to work here, lesson C in your workbook, pages 70 and 71. Okay, 70 and 71. That's your homework for tomorrow. So I hope that Luis can join us tomorrow and Diana also. Yes. Okay, Perla and Daniela, thank you for coming. Okay. And let's see, do your homework, study, and as I said before, the exercises are on WhatsApp. Okay. So have a nice evening and see you tomorrow. Okay. And thank you. Thank you for being here. Take care, please. You too. Thank you. Bye-bye.